Hello everybody. In today's class, we are going to solve one more problem related to oversubscription. In the previous two sessions, I have already done two problems related to oversubscription. There is one more problem I am going to do in today's class related to oversubscription. Slight different adjustment in this. So I thought of doing this problem. In your problem, they may give as oversubscription, or they can also ask problems on excess application money refunded and adjustment towards allotment. So they can ask oversubscription, or they can also tell excess application money refund also. Both means the same. So in the case of oversubscription only, we are going to refund the application, excess application money. Okay, so in case of oversubscription, how the adjustment will be made towards allotment? If there is any adjustment related to allotment, how that will be made, that we can see through this particular problem as an example. Okay, so Bharat Company Limited issued 10,000 shares of 100 rupees each, payable as under: on application rupees 20, on allotment rupees 40, on first and final call rupees 40. Okay, 40 plus 40 80, 80 plus 20 100. So total 100 rupees per share. It is collected in the three different stages: application, allotment and first and final call. Okay, next, applications were received for 15,000 shares. How many shares actually they issued is 10,000, but they received applications for 15,000 shares, of which applications for 3,000 shares were rejected and their application money refunded, and the remaining 2,000 share application money on 2,000 shares are adjusted towards allotment. So in this 15,000, 3,000 they have rejected, and remaining 2,000 they have adjusted in the allotment. Okay, so for 3,000 we have to do the refunding entry we have to pass. All the calls were made and all the money were duly received except the first and final call on 500 shares. The directors forfeited these shares and then reissued at rupees 75 per share as fully paid up. Pass the journal entry. So this is your question. As per this, only the adjustment here we need to see how the allotment is done in case of excess application. So in this, they issued 10,000 shares, but they got applications for 15,000 shares, and in that 15,000, 3,000 applications are rejected. That is 3,000 shares applications are rejected. For that we have to refund, and 2,000 applications that we have to adjustment, we have to do it in the allotment. Okay, now coming to solving the problem, you can just see this is the format: journal entries in the books of Bharat Company Limited. That is important, you have to write. Starting with the first entry, starts with application. So here they have not mentioned whether it is equity or not, so we will directly, we can take share application directly. No need to mentioning of equity share application, we can directly write applications. First, bank account will be debited since we are receiving money. Bank account debit to share application account. Share application account. Okay, so narration for that being application money received. Application money received. So how do you calculate here? You are receiving applications for 15,000, so we need to calculate for 15,000 for first entry. So 15,000 into application money is 20 rupees. So 15,000 into 20, you are getting 3 lakhs. So application money, total application money that they have received is 3 lakhs. Okay. Next, coming to the next entry. Don't forget to draw the line to maintain neatness. Then the second entry for transferring the application money to share capital account. In this stage itself, we have to do the adjustment towards allotment also. So first let me write the entry, share application, share application account data to, we are transferring to share capital account, share capital account. Okay, and we need to do the refunding, that I'll show it in the next entry, to share allotment account. And we, if you want to show the refunding also, we can show it here itself, to bank account. See, for transferring the share application money to share capital account, this is the entry usually that we are going to write, is it? And to refund also, we can do it here itself. Share application account data to bank account, it is the entry. I'm just writing two entries, I'm joining together and making here as a compound entry. Do you remember compound entries in first PUC? So same, that compound entry, I have merged two entries here. Since there is share allotment adjustment here itself, there is no difference. If you want, you can write separately for refunding also. So I just wrote here itself all two adjustments, transferring of application money to share capital, and 2000 applications, that is transferring to allotment account, and 3000 shares, that is we are going to refund, that is bank account. So I have done all together in one entry itself. Okay, being, I'll show you how to calculate application, being application money adjusted towards share capital, share capital and share allotment and refunded. All I am doing in one journal entry itself here. Okay, so total number of shares that we have received is 15,000. For 15,000 shares, we got the application. Okay, the application money is 20 rupees. But we are transferring for share capital amount is only 10,000, because that is what the actual issued number of shares. Okay, then 3,000 shares we are rejecting, we have to pay back to them. So 3,000 shares into 20, and share allotment, 2,000 shares we are adjusting with the share allotment. So share allotment, that is 2,000 shares into 20. So 20 rupees is nothing but the application money. Okay, so now you can calculate 15,000 into 20, it is 3 lakhs. And here 10,000 into 20, 2 lakhs. And again here 2,000 into 20, 40,000, 3,000 into 20, 60,000. So 60 plus 40 is 1 lakh, 1 lakh plus 2 lakhs, 3 lakhs. Debit side and credit side both, if you add, you will get the same amount only. So here you can see, I have done the share application money is transferred to share capital account, as well as whatever the 2000 adjustment we have to do for the allotment, that we have done here, allotment account transfer to allotment account of 2000 shares. And then 3000 shares are rejected, we should pay back, so bank account is credited. Okay, for that the narration we have to show all this application money adjusted towards share capital, share allotment and refunded, all that we have to show it in the narration, because the narration is gives the brief explanation for this entry. So that is the reason we have to give the narration clearly. Okay, the next coming to the allotment stage, the next entry for allotment. So allotment prize money, allotment charges is 40 rupees. So that is third entry. Third entry for allotment. Share allotment account. Debtor 2 share capital account. Share capital account being allotment money due, being allotment money due. So from here we are going to calculate for only 10,000 shares. So 10,000 share was the actual share issued, right? So 10,000 into allotment price is 40 rupees. So you will be getting 4 lakhs. 10,000 into 40, 4 lakhs. Now the expected amount for allotment is 4 lakhs. Okay. Next we have allotment money receipt. So when allotment money is been received, here you already have done the some adjustment here that we have to consider. Okay. So here when we are receiving allotment money, it will be bank account. So bank account debit data to share allotment account. Share allotment account ration being allotment money received. Allotment money received. So here actually expected amount is 4 lakhs. Okay, in this 4 lakhs already they have received some amount in as per the adjustment. Here we have done share allotment adjustment, right? That is 40,000. They have already adjusted 40,000 in the share allotment account. They have transferred 40,000. So that we have to deduct now. So 40,000 has to be deducted. Then the final amount, 4 lakhs minus 40,000, that is 3,60,000. So this is the adjustment, final adjustment done with the allotment stage. Okay. So this completes the allotment stage. Moving on to the next stage, first and final call. So first and final call, we are going to show it as due. So share first and final call account debtor to share capital account. To share capital account narration being first and final call money due. So on 10,000 shares we have to calculate allot first and final call amount is 40 rupees again. So it will be 4 lakhs. So for the first and final call, the amount that they are expecting or they have to receive is 4 lakhs. Okay, moving on to receiving part. Now as they have given in the problem, you can see they have told clearly 5,000 shares were not paid. sorry, not 5,000, it is 500 shares. In first and final call, 500 shares amount has not yet paid. So the calls in arrear is also there here. So bank account, debtor, since calls in arrears is there, it is debited. Calls in arrears account, debtor, to share, first and final call account. First and final call account. Narration being first and final call money received except on 500 shares. So except on 500 shares, all other money is received. So our total number of shares is 10,000 shares. In this 10,000, 500 shares not received. Remaining is how much? 9,500 into 40 rupees. 40 rupees is the call money. First and final call amount is 40 rupees. So calculate now. 9,500 into 40. It will be 3,80,000. 500 into 40, 20,000. And here 10,000 shares were actually expecting at 40 rupees each. So it will be 4 lakhs. Okay. Next, moving on to forfeited shares. Once the call money is not paid, then it will be called as call scenarios. Now call scenarios is created means obviously we have to forfeit the call scenarios. So the next entry, share capital account debtor to forfeited shares. To forfeited shares account to calls in arrears. To calls in arrears. Okay. So narration for this being 500 shares are forfeited. The calculation from here onwards you should calculate on 500 shares only. So 500 shares into actual price is 100 rupees per share. So here 500 into application plus allotment price you have to add. Application was 20 rupees, allotment is 40. Total it is 60. And calls in arrears account it is 500 into the first and final call amount is 40. Okay, this is how we are going to do it. Now calculate 500 into 100. It is 50,000. 500 into 60, 30,000. 500 into 40, 20,000. See, 30 plus 20, it is 50,000. Debit said also 50,000 total, it is correct. Please cross check when you are solving, because that is how it should tally. If not, your answer will be wrong or your entry may be wrong, that you can cross check it. Okay. Now the forfeited of the shares is been done. The next is for reissue. So when we are reissuing, the bank account comes here. Bank account debtor, forfeited account, forfeited shares account, debtor to share capital account being narration being reissue of 500 forfeited shares. So 500 shares were reissued at 75 rupees. 75 rupees they are reissuing, and actual price of each share was 100 rupees. So 100 minus 75 is 25. Now the forfeited shares here amount that we need to adjust is 25. 100 is the total actual face value of each share, and they are reissuing at 75. Okay, so 100 minus 75. It is 25. 25 is the final adjustment amount that we need to do. So 500 into 75, it is 37,500. Again, 500 into 25, 12,500. 500 into 100, 50,000. So when you add these two, 37,500, 12,500, 50,000, you are getting total. Add these two, you will get the same amount. It should tally, okay? So the next, the last entry will be from the forfeited shares, whatever the extra amount we have received, that we are going to transfer it to capital reserves. So forfeited shares account debtor to capital reserves. So whatever the extra amount, how you get the extra amount means the amount which is already paid, application and allotment money is been paid. Since they didn't pay the call amount, that will be cancelled. So once the share is cancelled means which is already allotted, those whatever the amount paid for application and allotment, it will not be refunded. So that is transferred to company's reserves only. And here again, when they are reissuing, they are reissuing for 75 rupees. In that 25 rupees, the company will be adjusting using this amount. 30,000 is there in the company's account, which is not going to refund it for the shareholder who got cancelled. So with this 30,000, this 25 rupees, that is 12,500, will be adjusted, and the remaining it will be transferred to capital reserves. So that we need to show it here. Narration being forfeited shares transferred to capital reserves after reissue, after reissue of shares. Now how do you calculate this amount? If you remember, the first forfeited shares amount will be there, no, first entry. This is the first entry for forfeiting the shares. So that is 30,000. So 30,000 minus the second entry's forfeited value is 12,500. 12,500. So just find out now. 30,000 minus 12,500. So you are getting 17,500. This is the final amount which is going to be transferred to capital reserves. So in this 30,000 of total forfeited shares amount, 30,000, they are adjusting this 12,500. And the remaining 17,500, it will be finally transferred for the capital reserves of the company. So this is all about the forfeited shares in oversubscription and oversubscription along with the adjustment towards the share allotment. Only thing here, adjustment we have done in allotment also. That is an extra thing. All other entries are same to same. Hope you understood this. If you have any doubts related to this, please let me know. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.